All right. Hi, everyone. I'm Siris Rivas-Verdejo, and we're here for Choosing a Different Future. I have a returning guest. So, so glad we can have Lisa Murray back on our show. Hi, Lisa.
Hey, Siris. How are you today?
Great, great. I'm so glad we can chat again. I love the background of where you're at. I didn't mention this. It's gorgeous. Every time I talk with you, you always are surrounded by beautiful things.
Well, you know, art and plants, they're good. And crystals, actually, there's crystals there too. So yeah, all the yummy things.
I love it. I love it. It's wonderful to surround yourself by beautiful things and remind yourself of the outdoors. I know you're a lover of the outdoors as well. So we haven't chatted in about 6 months. What has been showing up in your world and in your business in the last 6 months?
Oh, yeah. Wow. Well, you know, it's so funny. When you said 6 months and you said March, I'm like, oh, my gosh, so much has changed since March. Because, you know, when we last spoke, I was house sitting and trying to work out where I wanted to live and, you know, all of these sorts of things. And I was just at the very beginning of running Glow Wild, which was a 6 month program. And, you know, since then, I've moved to Mullaney. I've been living in an off-grid cottage, which has been really quite an adventure. I'm going to say that. And, you know, it was only ever designed, this one, for weekend use, not like full-time use. So there's definitely been a couple of compromises, but it's been a very interesting experience. And I'm really, really glad I did it. But I'm going to move to a different cottage in a couple of months that's just a bit more functional, you know? But so I've been having adventures. In essence, I've been having adventures, as I always do. And it's really interesting because I've always, for quite a long time now, thought, okay, I'm going to have a farm at some point. And to experience the off-grid and to see it, okay, in this sort of cottage environment, and then to see my neighbors, and they have like a really big setup, and to realize that it's possible to have a normal functioning house totally off-grid is fascinating, you know. And so that's just been a real adventure. And of course, things that have come with that have included snakes in the bathroom, a koala in my driveway, you know, like all sorts of interesting adventures. The wildlife, let's just say the wild bit in my life has really seemed to turn the energy up a bit. Yeah. Like birds come and fly around inside, you know, like you name it, it happens here. So yeah, we've been having lots of fun with that stuff. And what else? Oh gosh, so many things. Do you want me just to talk?
Well, I would love to actually, for the people that aren't as familiar with Australian geography, like where is in relation to everywhere else?
Okay. So I'm living in a place called Mullaney, which is in the Sunshine Coast hinterland. So it's on the east coast. It's about an hour north of Brisbane. And it's like back from the beach about, say, 35, 40 minutes. Okay. And it's beautiful. Like it's like you have the best of everything because you're in the bush. It's 5 minutes into town and there's like beautiful shops in town. Like it's what I would call a tiny creative town, which is very nice actually. And I'm really enjoying living here. So, and it's funny because, you know, I spent like 8 months or so, like really house sitting and looking at all different places. And this was one of the first places I house sat. And then when I was like, okay, I really need to find somewhere to live that's more permanent. It was just obvious. It was like, okay, this is the place. So yeah. And I mean, I don't know how permanent is, you know, because I've got another plan. I've always got another plan.
Yeah. I know who I'm talking to.
Yeah, exactly. Well, you know, I've got some business ideas that are very different to what I'm doing at the moment. And one of them, I didn't really do a test run of the idea because the idea is much bigger than the test run I did. But on the weekend, I did a test run because I literally took my art, which you can see behind me, to an art and craft show here in Mullaney on the weekend. And it didn't really sell at all. People were like, oh, it's beautiful. But they wouldn't buy it because, you know, and I didn't even price it that expensively, but it was definitely a pricing thing. So it gave me a whole lot of information of, oh, okay, my other adventure, I'm not going to be doing it here. So I'm going to enjoy living here while I'm here, but I suspect that at some point I'm going to move, you know.
So you have the possible move to more permanent, quote unquote permanent location. Because you're saying that one is more for short-term living, what makes it so it's not really feasible and sustainable for you to live there?
It's not that the cottage won't be sustainable. Oh, the one I'm in or the one I'm moving to?
The one you're in.
Oh, because when it's off grid, so if it's raining, for example, you have to run a generator. Okay. When it's off grid, when it's not set up for full-time living, let me put that really clearly, because I don't want people to think, oh, that'd be terrible. Because so my neighbors, for example, they never have to run the generator. They've got a backup generator in case they need it. But, you know, and I don't like running the generator and things like that. Just, there's just some power grid issues that, because this was not set up full-time, you know, for full-time living. So yeah. So the next cottage is not off grid, and it will just be, it's very, going to be in a very social adventure, basically. It's like a very social street. Apparently everyone walks their dogs in that street, and there's horses and all sorts of things, so I'm going to be having fun.
Many things you love, I can see. And then the farm idea, is there a particular type of farming that you'd like to do, because there's so many different ways to farm?
Yes, I know. I don't know yet. I think that's a little in the future, that one.
Okay.
And so, yeah, I'm not sure what sort of farm it's going to be, because the more I learn, the more I'm like, oh, it could be that, and it could be that, and it could be that. And, you know, so there's, I think there's a lot of unknowns. And I think, too, you have to work with the land that you actually have, you know, like to have a farm. It's not like, oh, I'm going to have a farm and it's going to be like this. It's going to be.
Yeah, and you're going to impel that agenda the onto land. The land.
Mm-mm. Yeah, here's the land and what is possible with this land, you know. I think. It's very much like that. And, you know, that is really how we need to look at life, I think, as well as, you know, we're very good at imposing our points of view on what it should be. And I think if anything I've learned in this last 12 months is this thing of, okay, so what can it be? You know, and I love that your show is about futures, because, of course, you know, I run a class called Creative Futures, and I've been to Europe, and I just recently, just a couple of weeks ago, and I ran the class in the Netherlands. And it's really interesting, because I think when we think about future, we're always, you know, and here I am, like, you know, here's my plans and it's all fun. And yet they're very flexible futures in my world. You know, what I say to you today may be totally different 3 months from now. And so, because what I know is that every piece of information that comes gives me something more, you know, it gives me more insight, and it gives me more awareness of exactly what I'd like to create. And so every time I have an adventure, it's really going, well, okay, what information or what awareness can this give me? And, you know, like selling my art on the weekend was fascinating. Men were absolutely intrigued and engaged by it. And that's not something I would have expected at all, you know. And
that's interesting.
So,
why is that?
Yeah. I don't know. I just, they were much more engaged than the women, like noticeably so.
Ah.
And I'm talking,
it was more
like,
that it was like more instead of like not, yeah. Like, not like you weren't expecting any interest. It was just that it was so much more from the men.
Yes.
Being
drawn
to the art.
And like that, and I'm talking like blokey Australian men, you know?
Yeah.
And that was really fascinating for me. And I was like, oh, you know, and it showed me that the world is changing, actually. That's what it showed me, you know, that they would feel the softness in the energy and, you know, all those different things that my art includes. So, yeah.
I love the photos you posted on Facebook. For anyone listening to this now, please go and check out Lisa Murray on her Facebook page. She posts these beautiful little tasters, little nuggets of her artwork that just makes you, every time I see it, I'm just like, ooh, it just like pulls you right in. I love it. And on top of that, it's so funny. If you guys didn't get to check out the talk that Lisa and I had back in March of 2019, you can go back to the website and check out that video as well. Because one of the things you mentioned then, Lisa, I don't know if you remember, is this idea. You're like, that's like forever ago. I know.
Yeah. That's like 10 lifetimes ago. What are you talking about?
Me too. But one of the things that I loved that you mentioned then that we're actually touching upon again in a different way is this idea that there isn't just one future, that there are many futures, infinite futures that are being created at the same time. And just like you're saying now, or get this bit of information, and it's not just that it feeds into a singular future. That input, that information is feeding into all of these possible futures. And that, even just saying that right now, I'm getting this lovely goosebumps. Oh, it's so,
Woo,
it's so yummy. So thanks for reiterating that. And I love that even that you're this walking example of creating multiple futures at the same, like, you're just like, not only am I interested in this, but there's this and this and there's this and this. And I love that as well. And at the same time, I'm wondering how you're managing to do all of this while still nurturing your body, while still glowing wild, like your program was talking about, like, cause you are glowing, my dear. I tell you, like, I invite anyone watching this now to go back and see Lisa in the other episode. I told her, I was like, honey, what are you doing? Whatever you've been doing the last couple of months, you look at least 20 years younger. And there's this glow about you, like you're even more exuberantly yourself. So how do you do that with your body?
Yeah. You know, it's funny. I'm not sure if I know. What I think it is, do I know? Being settled in one place has definitely been helpful, right? Because literally it is a way of, you know, and I think it's the thing of choosing to do a lot of things that I really enjoy. Being settled has, like, you know, on my veranda, I've got a whole art studio. Like the way it's set up here, even though it's a tiny, tiny space, it works really well because I've got this entire art studio. And, you know, we did do the 6-month Glow Wild program and it definitely made a difference. You know, there's when you start to unleash who you really are without any point of view of what that is, what it looks like, whether the world will like that or not, there is a magic that emerges from that, you know. And I think that the less I apologize for who I am and what I'm choosing, and the more I'm just like, okay, here I go, this is what's available right now and this is where I'm going, that really makes a difference. I would also say, like, the last couple of weeks I haven't been so good because, you know, I went to Europe and I bought a lot of chocolate because European chocolate really is the thing. But generally speaking,
That like that's a bad thing.
Well, for your liver, it's not maybe the greatest thing, you know.
Yeah.
But I'm really quite obsessed with, you know, like detox. And
yeah,
not detox,
that's true. We did that, really, talk about that. Yeah.
Not that hardcore kind of thing. Much more about being very gentle with your body every day. And actually looking at, well, what does your body want to eat, for example, rather than what do me want to eat? You know, when I was in Paris, I went to Paris for a few days and I found these most incredible croissants. Well, they weren't croissants. They were not shaped like a croissant, but they were croissant pastry with salted caramel inside. And honestly, I could just have kept eating them like as for every
meal. So you're gonna email me where that was, right?
Like, yes,
I love going to Paris and the food is a big part of that.
yeah, it was so, they're incredible, right? But, you know, there would have been a time when I would have found them and eaten them for breakfast, lunch and dinner. And I noticed that this time my body didn't want that. It was like, yeah, you can have one every couple of days. And I was like, oh, really? You know? And so,
darn.
Yeah, I know. But this is what happens when you start feeding your body like really whole food, what I would call whole food rather than, you know. And when I say that, I eat a lot of fruit for my sugar. I still have a lot of sugar, but it comes in fruit rather than sugar.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I've been making a lot of raw chocolate and stuff like that. And I think that when you eat that stuff, when it's food with nutrients in it, it makes a difference to the entirety of your body, you know? Mm. And so, I mean, there's probably a lot of things that, I don't know, make me look different. I don't really know, to be honest. I haven't analyzed it. But I think the aliveness is a big part of it as well. Because when you feel really alive and when you actively allow yourself, and it's interesting because the last couple of weeks I've been extremely tired, like off the charts tired, and not sleeping like at all, 2 or 3 hours a night. Like last night's the first good night's sleep I've had, you know, in probably 2 weeks. And I can't say that yesterday I felt nearly as alive as I do today. And so I think there's this thing where if you be present with the moment, then there is possibilities that emerge, you know. And we're very good at sort of going, oh, I don't feel alive, and thinking there's something wrong, rather than just going, okay, what can change? You know, I went to bed last night, a friend of mine worked on me energetically while I was asleep, and I'm sure that made a difference as well. So there's...
Thank you, friend, wherever you are.
Yeah, totally. Totally. Yeah. And so I think that this aliveness that you're perceiving in me is something that is choice by choice, moment by moment, you know. Mm-hmm. And it literally is about setting yourself free. And when I say setting yourself free from everything that doesn't work for you. And that's, I've been really consistently doing that this last 6 months. Like if there was one thing I've done, I'm not the best at consistency, right? It's hardly my strong point. But if there's one thing I've done, it literally is that. And I just kept looking at what would allow me to feel more alive, what would allow me the wild that I am, you know, like, because when I look at it, I've never been a conventional person. I tried really hard to fit in at different times in my life, but I've never been actually a conventional person. And I've been setting that free in many, many ways, and not as a resistance or as a fight energy, but literally as, okay, this is who I am. Let's let it out there. Let's see where it goes, you know?
You definitely see more, like, it's the word that when you're talking earlier, it's like as if you've unleashed even more of yourself.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely.
Wow.
I definitely have. Yeah. You know, and I think that comes back to things like when I ran the Creative Futures class in the Netherlands, for example, like it was a class like I've never done before. And I've done some good classes over the years. And that one, I was just like, oh, wow, we have gone somewhere new, you know, like in terms of my capacities with what we were doing. And so there's, my sense is that the more you really get in tune with who you truly are, as opposed to the, you know, how do I say this? There's so many ways that people try and fit in and they don't realize they're fitting in, you know, and what I've really done, I think, in those last 6 months is just kept on my own paths. And it is paths. There's not just one, you know, but really been really acutely aware of, is this my path or is it something someone else wants for me? Mm-hmm. You know, because mm-hmm. I've spent a lot of time in past years creating things that other people wanted from me, for example. And could I? Yes. I mean, I'm very capable, you know. Did I really want to do that? No, not really. And so this is the year of the wild in many, many ways, you know.
Oh, I love that. The year of the wild. Woo, that's another goosebump moment there, Lisa.
Yeah.
I like it.
Well, you know, we started with Glow Wild earlier in the year, and I'm about to launch Wild Hearts, which is a membership for people who really want to engage with these energies I'm talking about, you know. And it really is a pleasurable way to live. And a way that allows you to experience a really great diversity of life, you know, because when I watch all the animals, I think, and part of this has come literally from all the animals that have come to visit me here, you know, because there's been lots and lots of them, and that having that communion with the animals and just seeing how they show up in the world has really given me so much insight into, gosh, we're a long way away. Even those of us who maybe are, you know, I don't want to say more evolved, that sounds so, you know, icky, but even those of us who maybe have been aware of the possibilities for a long time, we've got so far to go. Like, I watch an animal and I'm like, oh man, we've still got so far to go, you know.
There's still so much more possible,
Yeah, there really is. There really is, you know. And, so I just think it's about really diving deep into the adventure. And allowing yourself to have the experience rather than trying to get it right all the time.
Wow. So, and it's interesting because this, with the unleashing that I've been sensing with you and this glowing out, it's, you know, you're talking about having the whole foods and having things that are more complete and not maybe not as processed and really listening to your body. It's almost like making sure that all these different choices, be it with food, with rest, with travel, with business, that it's including the whole entirety of you. That there is. So, wow. Okay. And I love that. I'm totally vibing with that. I think that that's exactly what's been shifting a lot of me. There's definitely been this piece, and it's a conversation I had with you actually, that I'm going to give you some credit for this, Lisa. I really appreciate it, where I was in a moment about my business, with my business, where I was very concerned about burnout And I was very concerned. I was like, I know I love all the different things that I'm doing, and yet something's got to change here. This isn't sustainable. Yeah. And it was this piece. You said, you know, is it possible? And I'm not quoting you verbatim.
No, sure.
But it was something like, you know, is it possible that it's time to change your business model?
Yeah.
And that's exactly one of many things that needed to change for me to actually look at me in totality with my business in totality, and also recognizing that the business had multiple futures.
Yeah.
And in addition to me having multiple futures. And I love that when you talk about glowing wild, that there's almost these, like, not even, for lack of a better word, layers. It's like, it's you're having this infinite possibilities and infinite futures being created. And everything and everyone that you're interacting with is also having this multiplicity of futures that are going on, that are interacting with yours. And this conversation I had with you, and it's really any conversation I've had with you, it's always like, oh my goodness, this now. So, wow. That's the piece that started happening. And I started looking at what you just mentioned, where I was still trying to fit in. Mm-hmm. Where I was still locking myself up in any kind of box, in any kind of definition, and being like, all right, let's be even more undefined here. Let's really look and shift things around. And if I didn't actually need to fit in with any particular thing, person, concept, what would I choose?
Yeah.
And things started changing. Oh my God, I'm getting teary-eyed, Lisa. I'm so, so grateful.
Aww.
For our conversation. I am not in burnout. I'm nowhere near it. I'm having fun. It's so much more congruent with the life that I've been asking for, that I've been desiring to have, and it's showing up. And I see that with you too. And yet it's so different from some other conversations we've had in the past of where you thought you might be around this time. And yet it's so awesome what you're creating.
Yeah. Oh, you know, it's fascinating to me how this works, because, sorry, I've got a mozzie flying around my head. So if I'm swiping at things, it's a mozzie that you can't see, but I don't want it biting me. But it's one of those really, and I'm so glad that, you know, that has changed for you and it's come how it has, because, you know, that is, I think, the real magic of when you look at, and business models is such a good topic. Like, it's one of my favorite things when I do coaching with people. I love looking at business models, because it's so easy to fall into the trap of thinking, oh, we have to do it how it's always been done, or, you know, this is the way to do this. And for me, business models have always been like a creative adventure, you know, in terms of just exploring, well, if it didn't have to be anything like what we think, what could it be like? And even at the moment, mine is changing dynamically. You know, I'm starting to do more one-on-one coaching, which I haven't done a lot of that for a long time. And it's just really interesting, all of the different things that are, oh, sorry, that mozzie, it's going to die soon. it's like, it's got a death wish. Yeah. But it's like when you play with business models and you start to evolve them, you know, beyond what has existed. And I think this is where it gets really interesting, is that we've come from a very patriarchal sort of set of business models, you know, where this is how business is, and it has to be the hustle, and it has to be this, and it has to be that. And I think we're moving into a very different time where business is going to change dynamically. It has to change dynamically. I mean, you know, we're ruining the planet with how we're doing it right now, and, you know, all sorts of different things are going on. So, and we're ruining ourselves. Like, we're really doing ourselves a great disservice, because there actually is no joy in working and never actually feeling like you're doing for you or being you, you know. Like, and that wholeness that you picked up on, it's an incredible thing. The more whole you become, the more you realize it's not just about business, it's not just about money. Are those things relevant and part of it? Absolutely. But if you make them the source of your choices, oh my gosh, you end up with a miserable life. And to bring that very, you know, it's very interesting. Sometimes I feel like I just go in circles, right? My very first, when I first started my business, I was a business coach, and I called myself a holistic business coach, because it literally was about this thing. And of course, it's like the spiral where you just keep getting more and more and more awareness of this thing that you're doing. And I've gone in and out of, you know, coaching because I sometimes enjoy it and sometimes I'm like, okay, I've had enough of that for now. You know, I want to do other things. And what I think is that each time I come back to it, there's something new and something, and when I say something, sometimes a lot of things new in there that really take it to a whole other level. And I think this is the same for business, and it's the same for all of our choices if we allow it. You know, we can be always evolving and getting closer to that true wild sort of, you know, being that we originally were and are. Because it's just like taking off all the layers. I just see it as taking off layers of stuff that isn't really who we are. And as we remove those layers, and not necessarily just energetic layers, but often it's our choices. You know, we take our choices in different directions and we realize, oh, that stuff over there, none of that was actually really my thing.
Yeah.
You know? And it's even the way, like, it's funny you're saying about the plants and the art and all the decorative stuff. Even that for me, you know, I've gone through really minimal periods and I've also gone through these really sort of lush and let's have lots of beauty in there. And I think that all of these things reflect where we are in, you know, in our adventure. And it's a really good thing not to get stuck in any one place.
And be willing to shift and change at any given moment. Yeah. You know, and it's interesting what you say with the coaching and things like that as well, is there it with business and with living. And actually, I'm going to rewind a little bit because there's something you said even before that about business models that kind of is still calling right over here. So I'm going to address that. Sure. And it's this idea that you said, well, there's so many different business models. I don't think people know that that there are that many. And you can't even enumerate all of them. It's not really possible. But even knowing that there's more than like two.
Oh yeah.
Totally. Right? And then on top of that, okay, how do these various, wow, so many different types of business models also interact with all the different ways you can choose to live and be in the world? Mm-hmm. Because it's also business models as, and I know you know this, it's not just businesses in brick and mortar or online business. It's also the business of living. Mm-hmm. And so I'm wondering if it would be helpful for people to hear from you at some point in the future. It's probably beyond the scope of our chat today, about what are some business models that exist, or maybe you already have a resource. You're a very prolific writer, so maybe you already have something written where you talk about the different business models and actually have people know, hey, did you know that this is possible and this is possible and this is possible? And maybe have like five versus just two. You know, that's still not all of them by any means of the imagination. But, it's still more than I think most people considered. And that's definitely the case for me. I was still, even five wasn't enough for me. I was like, these five aren't working for me. I need to create something else with my business than the five that I'm aware of. And even when I get to, okay, 10, that one of those 10 might not be what is required and what your business is asking for, but at least it gives you can pick and choose different aspects of all these different models and things you're seeing in the world and how other people are doing business, while also being willing to be like, hey, what do I know about this that maybe has never been seen, done, chosen, considered in the world? And that's what the conversation that I had with you brought up for me. There's things that I'm doing with my business that I was like, Oh, this, I don't think I know anyone that's done this before or is doing this. You know what? I'm not going to wait. My future is now. With my choices now, it's moving me there.
Totally. And I think there's two things to put in this bit of the conversation. One is that you are creating the future, right? You are actually creating the business models that people will go, oh, that's fantastic. In the future, right? As they follow on behind you. So that's one part to look at. And, you know, for me, when I look at business models, what I see is they're a a set of building blocks that you can put together in many, many, many different ways. And I do have some resources somewhere, because I mean, when I had Business Alchemy Lab, that's the sort of stuff I was writing about. So there would be something there somewhere. And I do know, you know, the building blocks of business models, you can put them together in many, many, many different ways. And I think this is the part I love about it, because it's a creative adventure then, right? It actually becomes something that you get to bring all your creative energy to it and go, well, actually, how would I like it to be in the world? How would I like business to be? You know, this is really, it is that full circle spiral kind of energy where this is where I started, you know, many years ago. Oh gosh, like I'd say 8-9 years ago, I had on Blog Talk Radio, a radio show called New Energies of Business. And literally this is what I was exploring, was all of these different things that make up business, but or could make up business, you know, because I think with business models, a lot of what we're looking at now is what does business need to be that it's never been before? Because for so long, it's been, been very narrowly defined, actually. And, you know, I love looking at a lot of the people who are really creating models that are good for the clients, good for the people that work for them, good for the world, the environment, you know, people who are really being creative in including possibilities for everyone, you know. So there's many, many things that are available to us that weren't before. And, you know, we have to thank technology and also not become a slave to it.
Both. It's so, both, please. Yes. There's been some moments where that very idea, I've been flowing more energy to that, because it's like, okay, the things that we put more attention and energy toward, we get to see more, we get to have more, we get to recognize more faster and quicker. And when there's those models that I see in the world, be it living models of people's choices or business models, I'm like, more of this, please. Every once in a while, I'll post something and I'm like, more of this in the world, please.
Yeah.
And people are like, it resonates with them. They're like, yeah. And then they start flowing their energy to it and their attention to it as well. And so, yes, I love that question. I wrote it down because I loved it so much. What does business need to be that it has never been before? Oh, I love that question. Wow, wow, wow. And yeah, I'm just going to.
Yeah, well, you know, when you look at it from that space, it stops being, oh my god, of this, it stops being all about work, right? It literally then can become a creative adventure.
And it really invites us to tap into our awareness and what we know, that even if other people haven't chosen it or you haven't seen it yet, it can bring that to the foreground and be like, oh yeah, what we can add this to this. We can add this to the world. We can consider this now. Yeah, I love that. I love that so much. So if people want to know more about the Wild Hearts program that you're about to do, where would they be able to find information about that?
If you go to www.lisamurray.co/wild, so not .com.co. Yeah. Okay. And it's all going to be there.
That in here, y'all. I'm going to make it super easy. We're going to not only have that link, we're going to have all of Lisa's information. Hopefully she'll be able to find that resource we mentioned about the business models as well. We're going to give her a chance to look for it between this recording and when it broadcasts so you can see it. But you can actually just email her directly and ask for that as well. And I believe in her website, you can message her and then request it through there, if I recall. Is that correct? Awesome. Awesome. So, yes, we're going to include all of that information. The Wild Hearts program sounds amazing. The Glow Wild was awesome. Is it possible for people to get the Glow Wild as a replay, or is that just like, is it enclosed group experience?
I think it's finished. And in saying that, it is on part of my possibilities list that maybe that I won't put the calls out, because they were private to the people who attended. And this is one thing going forward with my programs I'm very clear about. If you're on live, you get the calls. If you're not on live, and when I say on live, on the program, you know, I won't sell the calls later, because I just feel like that's been and done, and you know, that's that time. But some of the resources potentially may be recreated into something else. I'm not sure yet. It's on my list of questions for next year. But I think Wild Hearts is the expansion and extension of Glow World. So it's the place to go, really, if you want, you know, the live updated versions of all the magic that we began to create in Glow World.
Sounds awesome. Is that also going to be 6 months, or is that going to be an ongoing continuum?
It is ongoing. It is ongoing. And there's actually also a creation mastermind that is an option with that one as well. So that if you're really into the creation and you want like the business models and all that kind of stuff, we will have an option for that too, because I feel like it's really the time for us to turn it all up. You know,
yes.
It's really the time to go, okay, let's go. And of course, if you just want to go and do it for six months, you know, like how long you come and be a member for is up to you. That's not my job to decide that anymore. You know, yeah. I took that job off myself, but yeah, it's really a thing of like just opening up to what is available. Because I think that for a long time, we've been given this very, very, very limited menu. And the more I explore and, you know, I've been working a lot with channeling and those kinds of things as well, there's so much more that's available to us that we're not even looking at. And not to look at it from the space of overwhelm and, oh my God, it's another thing, but to look at it from what would I really, really, really like to choose, you know, because that's, I think, where we start to have this whole life that is, you know, really a reflection of who we are and what we came here to be.
Yeah. I love it. I love it. Thank you so much. That's so beautiful. And thank you for being such a gift to my life and hopefully an invitation to those that watch and listen to this later on, to consider this and to really know what's true for them with all these different areas of their life, including business and creation. I love it. Love it. Love it. Please feel free to come back again at any moment. There's definitely a lot of things we talked about today that I know we could talk about more, or we can go into more depth about. For everyone watching this and or listening to this in the future, you will have all of Lisa's contact information below the video. If you enjoyed our chat, feel free to check the like button and subscribe to our channel and ask her any questions either directly or post questions below the video, and she will get right on that and address that. Thanks so much for watching. Thank you again, Lisa, for being on our show.
Thanks for having me again. It was fun.
Awesome. Bye, everyone.
Bye.